Hey, brothers and sisters, I'm back for a second video tonight. I need to get into bed, but I've been busy dealing with about the orphanages. Seems we've got to increase our budget a little bit there, a couple hundred dollars a month. We've been calculating the budget increase of cost of food and all that. So praise the Lord, brothers and sisters, for those who've been, you know, sponsoring orphans and stuff. And just ask you guys who pray for the ministry to pray that God will continue to provide, which I know He will. I know He'll provide all of our needs according to His riches in Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:19. Brothers and sisters, I want to talk to you guys about a dream that the Lord gave me. The Lord gives me dreams and stuff and a lot, you know, personal things that I don't normally share. But this one is a little bit, I'm going to share this one because it's exciting. Of the times we're living in. We know that. We're living in the end times. But in my dream, brothers and sisters, I was in this classroom. And it was in a prestigious prep school, like. And it had on uniforms and all this kind of stuff. Like you see, some Ivy League or prep school, you know. It's like high school. Everybody was wearing uniforms. And I was there. And it was like a classroom of 30 or 40 people. And I was new there in that classroom where I didn't know the people, they didn't know me, but it was a Christian place. And it was, every day the teacher would tell someone, get up and tell us something that, you know, that God has been showing you, tell us something, you know. And people would get up and write on the chalkboard something, and then they would begin to speak, and they were telling things that was just basically... It was just like some Joel Osteen stuff they were telling. It was just a bunch of, as they say, my grandma used to say, mealy mouth stuff. It is mealy mouth nonsense. I mean, it's just weak stuff. It wasn't, you know, anything awesome. And it was watered down at best. So it was two or three days of that. And then surprised me because I was like new there. The teacher said, well, we have a guy here who is new, but he's already a fourth-year student. He's a senior here, but you guys don't know him. He's new, and he's a senior here, and he's about to graduate. And I'm going to invite him up here to tell us what the Lord is showing him. So it was me, you know. So I got up there in front of the classroom, and I went to the chalkboard, and the Lord spoke to me and said, right on the chalkboard, you know, behold, the Lord Jesus Christ cometh to judge the quick and the dead. No, I take that back. The Lord is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. Jesus is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. The Lord has emphasized that word. He's coming back. He's already been here before. He's coming back again. He's coming back to judge the quick and the dead. So I'll just give the whole detail of the dream. I tried to write on the chalkboard, but the chalk was a mix of black and white. You know, it was kind of gray. And the chalkboard was kind of gray. So when you wrote on it, you couldn't really read it. Because, there was no contrast. You know, that just reminded me of the video I just posted yesterday. Oh, excuse me. The Law of Contrast. I just loaded a video about that. The Law of Contrast. And so I didn't even think about that till just now. I was trying to round the chalkboard. So go back to my channel and watch that video if you haven't seen it. The Lord gave me that message just 2 days ago, maybe. Yeah, I think it's about 2 days ago by now. And I posted the Law of Contrast. And so anyway, there's no contrast. You couldn't read it. And I kept trying to write it again. And I wanted to write it really neat because these people were Ivy League people. My handwriting's kind of bad. I kept trying to rewrite it. And then I've clowned around with that for a minute. And then the Lord is like, just start talking. So I turned around and I started talking and telling them, you know, behold, the Lord Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. Now, those of you who don't know the King James, to be quickened is to be alive. You know, it's the King James word for life. So the living and the dead, the quick and the dead is the living and the dead. It's an expression that's used in the book of Acts, chapter 10. Peter uses it. And then 2 Timothy 4 verse 1, Paul quotes it again, and then Peter mentions it again in one of his letters. The Lord Jesus is coming back to judge the quick and the dead, the second coming of Christ. And so what was pretty cool, brothers and sisters, is to get into it. As I begin to start saying, why are you people worried about the police and about the government and all the things going on in this world? Because things were growing worse and worse. And the police, even though there's bad police, there are also policemen who are good. And they're trying their best. But the system, the government is what's getting more wicked and evil in the whole world. So therefore, don't look to these things. But, behold, Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. So when I said that, brothers and sisters, the place opened up and I could see. And what it was is, which is really wild, was that for me to even talking about the police and the police state and all that, it was already so wild because I would never think about speaking about that in reference to, you know, like preaching. But it opened up, brothers and sisters, and I was on this giant boat, like a love boat, you know, or something, a cruise ship or whatever. But it was a lot bigger than that. It was a giant ship. And me and the people that were in the classroom, we were like way up high, higher than the mast of that ship. Okay, so, you know, the interpretation of that part was these people that were there were studious students of the Lord and close to the Lord. Because when we were way up higher than everybody, and then I could see the walls were open and I could see people below at another level and on down, and then I could see, and I kept repeating the same message. And then I could look and see, every time I repeated it, I could see people at lower levels. Down and down and down, like stadiums, like if, you know, if you had like a football stadium, like the deck of the, you know, probably a better analogy is the Titanic, right? But because the world is going down in flames here, but a sinking ship, but it wasn't doing that in the dream, but it was like I said, like a cruise ship looking thing, but it was like an arena of people. Like at a sporting event. And then going down, there were layers of people. I don't know how many layers down, infinite layers of people going down. And every time I would say it, I could see the next level, and the people were listening to me. They all stopped and were looking at me. And I could hear people, at all the different levels saying, like a lot of people on YouTube, they never read the King James and they don't know these words, and they're like, what does that mean? Quicken the dead. What does that mean? And then when I was, you know, and so I was answering them, but the Lord kept having me answer with the same sentence. What it means is Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. And they were like, what does that mean? It means Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. That's what it means. And I kept repeating that Bible verse, you know, over and over and over again to the multitudes. And they were all stopped in their tracks. They were all looking up and listening. I had the attention of all those people. You know, so I believe part of the interpretation is not only maybe, you know, the Lord would allow me to speak to greater audiences, you know, than already on YouTube and, you know, to some higher level crusades or something. But also believe that God will do things to get people's attention much more. That people's attention will be gotten, like when the rapture happens, of course. That's going to be a big time attention getter, and it's going to really cause chaos and really have people freaking out. You know, what happened to these people? What's the explanation? You know, and there's lots of people who believe that the rapture will be the very event that causes the Antichrist to come to power. Because when the restrainer, the Holy Spirit through the church, when the restrainer is removed, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, we see the restrainer is removed, and then, you know, the church, brothers and sisters, is salt and light in this world. Even though there's lots of bad churches and bad, you know, people that are supposed to be Christians and all this, but the church is salt and light and a restraining force in this world. Now, the moment that the church is removed, the true church, there will be that vacuum of the God's occupying earth through his people. God is everywhere. God is, well, the, you know, the right theological expression, a lot of people say, you know, God is omnipresent. that God is everywhere. The real theological way of saying it is God is immediately available everywhere. You know, God is not in the speakers. God is, you know, God is not in this computer. They call that animism, where we say, oh, there's a God in the tree and all this stuff. You know, there's a God in the river. No, God is immediately available everywhere. He can be anywhere. You know, he's in another dimension. He's not, you know, in the river, but he's, you know, he's here. It's hard to explain. God is immediately available everywhere. He is able to be anywhere, anytime, any place. He's immediately available. But he's not in the tree, is what I'm trying to say. It's not part of God. The creation is separate from the Creator. I don't know why I started talking about that theology stuff. What can you do, brothers and sisters? I don't know when I'm thinking this. People's questions that I hear from people, it's in my mind, and when I'm making the video, it comes back to me to answer that question and talk about it, brothers and sisters. Praise God, that's why I'm on YouTube at this time, you know, to answer those questions that people would ask, that, you know, they... Lots of people that you talk to, even myself, I used to be when I was going to Bible school, I was an altar worker at a church of about 4,500 people, one of those mega churches. And you couldn't just go in there and ask the pastor anything, you know. As a matter of fact, I mean, how many people can you talk to, you know? So, I think I talk to a lot more people than most pastors do. I forced myself to be available. You know, I had people who are not preachers, you know, try to advise me, oh, you just need to make a list of Q&A and frequently asked questions and let people look at those answers. And I can do that, but I don't know why I'm changing topics here. I just want to be available for people as much as I can. You know, I mean, God gave me the wisdom in that area. Everybody has different talents and wisdom, brothers and sisters. There's some of you guys that can do lots of things I can't do. And different kinds of talents that we have. But that's the talent that the Lord gave me, you know, to understand His Word pretty good and, you know, to be called to be a pastor. And I think it's, you know, it's a privilege and it's something I love to do. As Paul said, woe is me if I don't preach the gospel. So that's how I feel about it, brothers and sisters. I want to help people. But sometimes, I don't know why I'm on this topic, but there are people that think they're going to bully you and keep stomping on me. But as a pastor, I'm supposed to take that. No, I help people who I can help. People that's trying to, you know, that's trying to wrestle with me and all that. You need to wrestle with God. You ain't wrestling with me. You got to wrestle with God. And I just give you over, as Paul said, you know, just give over. Paul said something different, but I give you over to the Lord. Paul said to turn people over to Satan, but, you know, I'll turn people over to the Lord. And, you know, those who I can't help, I'll give them to the Lord. Those who I can help, praise God, it's awesome. And I thank the Lord that probably 90% of the people I deal with, by the grace of God, I've been able to be some kind of a blessing to help them in their walk with the Lord. And that's why I'm on here, and that's what, you know, the Lord blessed me with that opportunity to do that. So, brothers and sisters, God bless you. I ask you to continue to pray, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video. We're going to be buying more land. If those of you who have been following my videos, we're buying more land to build a third orphanage. But I also need to increase the budget for the first two orphanages. Really, it's like $200 a month for one orphanage and $100 a month for the other orphanage that we're kind of short on the budget because of increased prices of food and whatnot and expenses we didn't calculate. And, you know, it's just, it's always something, right? And like I said, God's already been providing, and I know God will provide. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. Ask for your prayers as I'm going to be looking for the land. There's two or three different lands that I'm looking at, you know, to try to buy. And I just want to make sure I get the right one, what the Lord wants me us to get. So ask for your prayers about that. And continued success for the Lord. And if the Lord doesn't return anytime soon, I'll be coming back to the United States in May, middle of May, brothers and sisters. So I ask you guys to prayerfully pray. You know, I haven't actively been seeking a church to be the pastor of or whatnot. There are lots of churches that need a pastor, and I haven't, you know, done that or know necessarily that that's what the Lord would have me do. You know, go pastor a church or what in the States for the next couple of years or what. And where we're going to, what place we're going to live. I'm still waiting to hear from the Lord specifically. And, we need to do all these things. We need to get a vehicle, a place to live, and all that. Still unsettled. The Lord is still sending me around instead of being, in one place. I will be obedient to the Lord and keep going around if that's what He wants me to do. I don't like to say that I'm excited about it or that I want to keep going back and forth. But I will go back and forth to be obedient to the Lord and do the Lord's will. And I ask you guys to pray about that. And I thank all those who've been praying for Joshua's ministry and been praying for me and my family. I really appreciate that. There's lots of you guys. I'm praying for you guys. Who's asked me to pray for them? I'm praying for you guys. We've had lots of answered prayers through this ministry. Praise God for that. Through the prayer team, tons of answered prayers. We have the prayer team, and then the people can submit a prayer request. And I just wanted to mention, as I'm thinking about it, the host of our website is some kind of a scam. They said that, there's some spamware off of our website, Church First Born website. And then they charged us to clean it up, which they shouldn't. And then they keep trying to charge us every month and all this. So we need to find a new host. We're with iPage right now. We need to change that. So I ask you guys to pray about that. If any of you guys are a programmer, still looking for somebody to work with Brother Sid, we need to move the website off of that host to another system, whatever you call it, a host other than iPage. So God bless you guys. May the Lord be with you. And His word says He will. He says He will never leave us nor forsake us. So if you are a Christian, stand on the promise that Jesus said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I'll be with you even until the end of the age. So praise God for that. God bless you guys. I was going to show it on this video too. If you didn't see it, I'm wearing my Rapture shirt. For those of you who have been following that, praise God, because the Lord has been speaking to me about the Rapture and all that, and the other video I made tonight. And so I thought I'd dig out my Rapture t-shirt, which I had left here in the Philippines in my bags, and put it on tonight. Just a reminder that, no man knows the day or the hour, but the Lord will come as a thief in the night, and we will be caught up to meet Him in the air. So I'm just wearing it as a reminder to me and you that the Lord will come at an hour we least expect, He said. So praise God for that. Ready to go.